Live Network. This is Sportsline.
Good evening, Nashville. Welcome to Sportsline. It's the Wednesday extravaganza. John Burton with you. It's been a long time since we've gotten together. A lot has happened. The NFL draft. Tiger Woods won the Masters. And so much has happened over the big wild world of sports since we last got together. So definitely want to thank Steve Lehman for filling in for me the last couple of Wednesdays. But I am back. And today, speaking of golf, speaking of Tiger Woods, that's what we're talking about for the entire hour. PGA Championship coming up this weekend from my home state in New York. Of course, the PGA Championship moved up to the month of May. Normally it's in August. But they moved it up, so we're going to get all four majors in nice and tidy during the summer. And here to help us talk about that and so much more in the game of golf, one of our favorite guys to have on Sportsline, it's Virgil Herring, PGA teaching professional, director of golf at the Ensworth School, friend of Sportsline, friend of News Channel 5 Sports, does those great golf tips for our Sunday night show, the Electric Power Company Sunday Sports Central. Virg, it is an honor to have you back in studio, my man. What is up?
Man, it's golf season.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm eating pollen sandwiches every 30 minutes, but it's all great. And it's interesting to have the PGA Championship so early in the year.
Yeah.
And so that's great. A great venue. Bethpage Black has been a host of two huge U.S. Open championships. So I'm sure it's going to be a great golf course in unique situation because it's going to be cool and wet, unlike it would be in the summertime for a U.S. Open. But nevertheless, it'll be a stern test.
It's going to look more like a British Open probably than the PGA Championship with the weather.
Certainly with the weather, as in the weather of like the temperature and the wind. But it's going to play more like American golf because it's going to be so soft and that you'll have to hit shots higher, like in the British Open, you can kind of bounce it in. You won't be able to bounce anything in at Bethpage Black.
What led to the PGA's decision to move this major up to the month of May? Because normally, it's usually the final major of the year. Mm-hmm. It's usually what, in August? Normally,
it's in August, yes.
Yeah, like mid to late August. And from what I heard, it was basically, listen, we don't want to compete with NFL preseason, getting, you know, people getting ready, especially in this area, getting ready for college football in August, getting ready for pro football in August. I mean, what led to the PGA's decision to move this major up?
It was the Olympics, actually. So the Olympics fall in August every 4 years, so they couldn't just arbitrarily move it every fourth year.
Yeah.
So they decided to move the Players' Championship back to March. So now it's kind of like the five big tournaments, even though the Players is not considered a major championship. It's
It's like the unofficial fifth major,
So it's the Players, the Masters, the PGA, then the U.S. Opens on Father's Day, and then the Open Championship is in late July, and then it's the FedEx Cup, and then the FedEx Cup ends Labor Day weekend, and that's helping us avoid college football and NFL football for sure.
Well, you're a golf purist. Do you like that? Do you like the fact that this particular major has been moved up to the month of May?
Well, a couple things I'm looking forward to, which is the fact that we're going to see new golf courses because they generally have to, in the summer, they have to play northeast and like along the California coast because they can't afford to have it in 100 degree heat for most of the events. So now with it coming to May, now we'll see some Texas golf courses, maybe like Southern Hills in Oklahoma. And some probably they're going to be, because they're into doing these public golf courses, we might start to see some different venues than we've ever seen for major championship. And I think that's great for golf to expose, you know, the golf communities to different places other than the staples that we've been seeing for the last 40 years.
Okay. Well, you know, and perfect timing, actually, because everybody's gone golf crazy because you may have heard this, folks. Tiger Woods won the Masters. He came back, made one of the biggest comebacks in sports history.
Yeah,
we talked
sure.
about this on the show. Yeah. He wins the Masters after, 11 years being away from a major championship. Most people, myself included, thought he would never even win another tournament, let alone another major championship. Before we look ahead to the PGA Championship, I know how excited the golf world was to see Tiger back on top. What are your memories of what he was able to do at Augusta a few weeks ago?
Well, for me, when it comes down to what it takes for Tiger to win, is that as soon as he stopped becoming a great driver of the golf ball, right around 2005 or 6, that's what was the limiting piece. So all along, if he can't drive the golf ball, he can't win in the major championships.
Right.
So the fact that he drove the golf ball so well was huge. I mean, I would argue that he is the greatest iron player in the history of the game. And if he's not, he's in a very short list between he and Hogan and maybe Mo Norman of the greatest iron players of all time. Mm-hmm. So if he's in the fairway, he's a threat to win anywhere. It's just for a long period of time, he was never in the fairway. So that was awesome to see. I think it was great, and I'm looking forward to however long this lasts, because that's what I don't know.
Right.
Because I think it's more health-related than it is anything else.
Hey, because he said that, right? He said, you know, even a couple of years ago, he said, guys, I could still play. I'm still really good. It's just I have to get healthy.
Yeah.
And you look at the back surgeries he's had, the knee problems he's had, the other problems he's had away from the course.
Yeah.
I just didn't think he'd be able to get it together. Because one of the things I love about the majors, and I'm sure you do too, you know, I respect the game of golf. Mm-hmm. I don't play, but my dad grew up outside of Philadelphia. Him and his brothers used to caddy to make money for the family, and that's how he learned the game. My dad was a really good golfer, and I respect the game, and I love watching the majors, right? And what I love about the majors is probably what you love about the majors. I want to see the back nine on Sunday. Who is going to be able to hold it together to win that championship? Because you know this. You win one major, you're a made man for the rest of your career.
Yep.
If you win one. I mean, you know, Justin Leonard, I think, won one major, right? He won the British Open back in 96. People still remember that.
Mm-hmm.
So I didn't know. I just didn't think with the young guns coming up now, these really good young golfers, I just didn't think he would have enough to pull it together, because these guys aren't scared of him like maybe some of Tiger's peers were back in the late 90s, early 2000s. So I didn't think he would be able to pull it together. But what we saw in that back nine in Augusta was vintage Tiger.
Yeah.
And he even, actually, it was something we never saw before. He had to actually come from behind to win that major.
Mm-hmm.
And so obviously, he's always had the mental part of it now, but now, looking how well he looks physically, I mean, I think the threat to catch Jack Nicklaus is back on. What do you think?
As long as he stays healthy,
yeah.
I think that's the case. I think we're in for some interesting pieces, because I think that Rory and Spieth and Koepka and DJ and Molinari and Fleetwood, they all said, well, I really like the idea of taking on Tiger. It would be really cool to see what it was like.
Right.
And they don't. No, you don't. And I think that's what we're getting ready to see is,
right,
can these guys that are considered the heir apparents,
right,
Rory,
next
Koepka,
generation
Spieth,
kind of thing, yeah,
because they're the ones that have the pile,
right,
of majors,
right,
McIlroy with four, Spieth and Koepka with three,
right,
how well do they handle it? That's going to be the key, and I'm interested to see, can one of those, and I think the golf would love it to be Rory, because Rory's like that almost as popular guy.
Yep.
Spieth a little bit, but I think it's still, if Rory puts together something this weekend and he could take down Tiger, that would crank the volume up on the level of excitement for golf for, you know, a handful of years, because we always know that Tiger's going to be there. We've always expected Rory to be that person who takes the cloak off of Tiger's shoulder to put it,
right,
on his own. But it seems to me that there aren't many people that can handle the heat that Tiger can bring,
mm-hmm,
if he's in contention in their group.
Yeah.
I think Koepka can. I think Molinari can. Although, even though you could say, well, he didn't at the Masters, well, he did at the Open Championship.
He did. And you know what? You think about that final round that he had at the Open Championship. Tiger actually had the lead at one point on the
That's
back
right.
nine. But our boy Frankie Moe, we love him. Francesco Molinari, he's quickly becoming one of my favorites. He played a beautiful round of golf in that final round. Bogey free, just steady as she goes. And he was on his way to doing that in the final round at Augusta, and then he ran into some trouble.
On 12.
On 12,
And we'll never know, was it a bad shot or was it a bad club? Or for those of you who have never played Augusta National, the 12th hole is a pretty unique situation because the wind, it swirls in the trees there. So, like, when you think it's into the wind, it's mm-hmm. actually down, and you think it's down, it's actually into. And there is, like, there are very few times where I think experience matters mm-hmm. in golf.
Mm-hmm.
In that particular situation, Tiger had the advantage because you could tell that he aimed way farther left than the guys who hit it in the water had a chance to win. Finau, Koepka, and Molinari all had a chance to win. They all hit it in the water because they were aiming closer to the flagstick. Tiger's like, I'm playing over here left of the bunker. I'll take my chances from 50 feet to make a par.
Wow.
I'm not going to lose.
Right.
And I think that's what I try to teach when I'm out there. It's like, I would much rather you shake the hand of somebody who beat you mm-hmm. than have to look in the mirror to see who beat you.
Right.
So Tiger was willing to lose if one of those guys were going to hit a shot into that flag and make a birdie and take control of the tournament. it didn't happen, and that's what makes Tiger look so brilliant right now.
You know, it's funny. I remember back to 2008 when Tiger won his previous, you know, his yeah. last major before Augusta. And I was living in the Pittsburgh area at the time, and, you know, he had to face Rocco Mediate. They had to come back on Monday and play that 18-hole yeah. playoff. Rocco Mediate, as you know, is from Western Pennsylvania, just down the road from Pittsburgh, near where the great Arnold Palmer, God rest his soul, is from. So yeah. it was a big story locally. Obviously, mm-hmm. Tiger contending in a major is a big story anywhere, but yeah. it was also a big story locally. And along those lines, I remember, you know, we all know what happened. You know, Tiger was able to win despite having a broken leg and a broken back and goodness knows what else. And less than a week after that tournament, Rocco returned home, and we, you know, worked a few connections. We got a one-on-one interview with him. This was less than a week after, yeah. you know, we did the interview Saturday. He lost the playoff, obviously, on the Monday and had to travel all the way back across the country. Hmm. And I remember I asked Rocco, I said, what's the bigger feeling for you? You know, the fact that you went toe-to-toe with Tiger Woods or the fact that you didn't win the U.S. Open? And without hesitation, you know Rocco, he loves yeah. to talk. You know, he's without hesitation, he goes, the fact I went toe-to-toe with him. He's like, I'm more proud of that than maybe even winning the U.S. Open because I made him earn it.
Yeah.
He's like, Tiger's the best ever, you know, and arguably. I mean, you know, yeah. we could go back and forth with that. But, you know, at the time, he was certainly the best. And he said, you know, I made him earn it.
Yeah.
And so I think that goes along the lines of what you're saying. Don't beat yourself, you know. Play a smart game, a solid game. At times when you have to, play a safe game. And like you said, if somebody else beats you, then shake their hand and, yeah. and know that they earned it, right?
I think that that's the most interesting piece to competitive golf, is that more times than not, players allow their emotions to dictate their decision-making.
Right.
And they want to be a hero. It's easy to want to put that cape on and want the big S on the front of your shirt, but not many people are built to be a superhero.
Right.
You know, so not even Tiger. I mean, obviously Tiger's hit a bunch of unbelievable shots, but many times he had plenty of a lead to deal with. Now, obviously, right. the chip in at the Masters.
Had some wiggle room, right?
He had some wiggle room, and he had a sense for the. And in my opinion, nobody's ever played the game like Tiger. Jack holds the record for the most majors,
sure.
and it's hard to, like, you can't really discern, like you were saying. It's six of one, half dozen of the right. other. But I can tell you right now, even Jack Nicklaus would tell you that nobody's ever played the game like Tiger's played it.
Yeah.
And to see where that leads people in their decision making, that makes people feel like they have to be better than they are to beat Tiger.
Sure.
And that's where you start to see the people making bad decisions.
You like, start playing hero ball. We see that in the NBA, right?
That's right.
Yeah.
I have to do this or I can't beat Tiger.
Right.
I'm not good enough unless I do something heroic. Mm-hmm. And that's what he's waiting on you to do.
Right.
He's waiting for you to feel like you have to be something other than you're not, because then he's actually not having to beat you. You're beating yourself.
One of the things that I know you and I have always talked about in regards to Tiger Woods, you know, I used to tell you all the time, whether yep. it was on this show, whether it was on Sunday Sports Central, you know, I always say, you know, listen, like I said, I'm a golf fan. Well, I watch the majors. I don't necessarily watch the Valero Texas Open start to finish,
yeah.
but I enjoy the majors. I like watching the back nine. And I wasn't one of those people that was quote unquote Tiger dependent, because a lot of casual golf fans
yeah.
will say, look, I don't watch unless A, Tiger's playing, and B, he's in contention to win. And I didn't respect that for a long time, but seeing what happened at the end of the Masters when he won and the joy on his face and the fact that he was actually walking through on his way to sign his scorecard, slapping hands with fans mm-hmm. and hugging his kids and his mom.
Yep.
And just seeing like it was almost like a look of relief on his face. Obviously, he was extremely happy to win another major, but almost the relief, like, I can do it. I did it. I did it again after over a decade. When it comes to Tiger Woods, I get it now. Yeah. I understand why there's such a draw with this guy. Because, you know, we've talked about it on and off camera. He's just an interesting guy. What yeah. he's been able to do over the years leading up to it, and the struggle and the fight that he's had the previous, you know, the last 11 years to get back to this point,
yeah.
that says a lot about, you know, his character. Say what you want about him.
Yeah.
Look, the guy's had his share of issues off the course that we don't need to get into, but, you know, the guy's got some resiliency and he's got some character.
Well, I think what makes it compelling is this. You could argue that he's the greatest there's ever been in his sport.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody's ever been that high. then nobody's ever fallen that far. You can argue Mike Tyson maybe, but probably not.
But we kind of saw that coming.
Yeah, that was easier to see coming. That was easier to see coming. To then
with all due respect to Mike, you know, but we
coming out of that trough that very few people that come from great heights can fall to pull himself back out of that. Now everybody can relate to that because everybody faces struggles.
Right.
And that's what makes the Tiger Woods story. Now he's humanized. Before he was not human.
Yes.
It was like he was doing things that didn't seem possible. Golf tournaments were over by Friday afternoon.
Right.
It was boring. He did things that nobody ever thought about doing. Now he fell from grace epically.
Yep.
You know, opioid addiction, body falling apart.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the extramarital piece that makes it so compelling off the golf course.
Sure.
And his game was deteriorating. To then resurrect it, everybody can relate to either that kind of addiction pain, the loss pain, we're getting older pain.
Deal with that every day.
Everybody can grab a hold of something that's like it unified everybody. There aren't many things left that can bring everybody together.
Yeah.
And Tiger's win at the Masters brought everybody in sport together because they want to see that kind of comeback. It was awesome.
He's our PGA teaching professional, Virgil Herring, also director of golf at the Ensworth School. He is here for the entire hour. We'll take your phone call, 737-7767. If you have an issue with your golf game, maybe we can help you with that slice or that hook, right?
We'll take
some calls on that. When we come back, we're going to preview further this weekend's PGA Championship from Bethpage Black in New York and see if Tiger or someone else will be holding up the trophy when it's all over. Stay with us. We're back after this on Sportsline.